Timekeepers are ready. Okay, let's go now.
When I wake up, it's typically dark in Seattle, and so I like to use night mode or dark mode for my apps, now supported across all Microsoft 365 experiences. Boom, there's one.
Really? Dark mode? That was so cheap, my cat could have done that. I'm not gonna give you points for that one.
All right.
That's a theme.
Fine,
you can do that
when
Windows.
I'm on my way to work, I go hands-free responsibly by using Cortana to navigate with my voice.
I've just got one new email for you.
And there's the email from Andrew Roger reminding me that I need to do something about some catering pricing.
All right, that one's worth a point. So you got one.
Yeah. All right, now I don't know about you, I don't have a personal assistant that handles my calendar, but when somebody like, I don't know, Satya Nadella requests a meeting, it feels like probably
you better
something
do it,
I
gotta
do, right? So what I want you to see here is I've at mentioned Cortana and used natural language to ask Cortana and AI to find me a meeting time next week. And I've added Andrew to please join me for the meeting so that, you know, if things go wrong, I'll just blame it on somebody else, right? Okay, so I'm gonna send this message now, and in a matter of seconds, what's going to happen is AI goes out, schedules the meeting, calendar.help, and then we'll have a response back. There it is. The deployment status update has been scheduled for next week. Awesome.
Beautiful.
Now, Andrew was reminding me about Excel and this fact that I need to get this pricing to him. Now, my pricing showed up on this. Anybody get paper still? There's actually still a ton of paper processes.
Too much
paper. So
here's
my spreadsheet. I'm going to turn on the camera here. I'm going to focus it in on my invoice here. Take a quick picture. We'll crop it intelligently so that we are just extracting the tabular-based information. Go a little bit higher there, and then like that.
All right.
And then AI goes to work, turns it into a table, and in just a few seconds, you'll see I can drop that right there into my Excel spreadsheet.
It's a table
Pretty
in Excel.
Cool.
Once it happens, hold on. There it is, and it's
Boom.
In.
Insert, and there's your data.
All right.
Okay.
Nice one.
How we doing?
All right,
there's
another
a
point.
Lot. Okay. Well, there's Keep a going. Lot of great tools for collaboration. Here's the good news. But the bad news is sometimes it's hard to stay focused on all of your follow-ups and tasks. And for that, I use To-Do. Now, the new updated To-Do has connections to Outlook and to Planner. So what's awesome about this is while I'm organizing my day, and you can kind of see I got some very important things to do here, like don't mess up Demopalooza. Okay,
the
and
phone.
Then we're gonna go to Assign to Me, and here you can see shared task lists, things coming from Planner, even all of my follow-ups from Outlook. So I can really use To-Do to stay prioritized. And when I get in the office, I'm ready to rock and roll.
That's worth another point. Good job.
All right, now I'm in the office and I need to work securely and I'm gonna use the Edge browser to do that.
So Internet Explorer is not your go-to then?
Not really.
Okay.
But there's a lot of websites out there still using ActiveX, Silverlight, those types of technologies, and having two browsers is a less than ideal experience. So here I am in Edge. I'm going to navigate to a site that uses Silverlight. It's actually one of our sites.
Yes.
And you notice I'm engaged here directly in an interactive session. The page is opened in Internet Explorer. When I navigate away, we just go right back
it's
to
still
Edge.
It's still in Edge, but showing
no
through
mess.
Internet Explorer. That's
Very
worth
clean.
Another point. Keep going.
All right. Now, the next thing I want to show you is the new page tab, and you're looking at it right now. You can see all of the relevant information from Office 365.
MRU, trending stuff,
All that stands between me and the next inspiration is a
single All right, click. That's worth another demo. Keep going, you gotta catch up some time.
All right, so then what we now need to do is take a look at security and how we balance this with security. And so for that, I'd like to show you Microsoft Defender Application Guard.
Okay.
Okay, so if we can switch to that machine, here we have it. Now I wanna show you this. First off, it uses virtualization and containers to be able to isolate this application from the rest of your host. Let me show you what
and
I
this
mean.
This is the new Edge, as you can tell by the icon.
You gotcha, and this icon up here tells you it's opened inside Application Guard. Now you went to Hanselman's keynote, I hope, and you saw that the power toys are available. These are awesome, right? But maybe my IT department doesn't really want to let me install those, and you see when I try to open it, nothing is happening. When I try to open a file, completely isolated and protected. Let's go to
All right,
uploading
that's worth
a file.
That's worth the point. All
Let's
right.
Let's go upload a file. Where's my files from the container? Well, they're inside the container, so guess what? There's nothing there. And then when I close down the browser, poof, it's gone, nothing
there you
remains.
Go.
That's
Another
available
one.
Now. Let
All
me
right.
show you a
so
peek
that's
around
two points.
The corner.
Yep.
Last year, I brought the ransomware USB stick with the Windows Vista logo on it. Anybody wants to see this?
Everybody loves that thumb drive.
Hard
yep.
to believe it still exists. And I put it in here. We found it over on the walkway from the Hyatt. And so I thought, well, why wouldn't we just put it in and find out what's on it? It's labeled secret data. I mean, there's clearly something on here important. So I'm going to open up the Mark 8 competitive analysis. Now, there's going to be a delay here. And I want you to understand this is pre-release, still in the oven. It isn't, I'm losing a little time.
It's a
time.
Future build of Office. It's,
you should give me 10 seconds back, but that
I
may
might.
Not be sure. Application Guard for Office opens it up. Last year, we clicked the button. It went over here and said, you've been hacked. And then what it went to do was encrypt all of my documents. You'll notice it can't do that because it has no access.
What happens in the container stays in the container. That's worth another one. I might even give you 2 points for that one, because that one's pretty awesome.
I'm glad.
Virtualization-based security for Office coming out later.
All right.
All right.
Now let's talk about Excel, because Excel is one of my favorite applications, and Excel junkies everywhere are going to love some of the new stuff that we're doing. First is called dynamic arrays. Very simply, one function can return multiple values.
So let's go to this computer here.
So check
here.
This out.
Hold on. There we go.
All right. So check this out. Here's a function unique. So I'm just type unique. I'm going to highlight. Did you notice Brad shows up here a lot in this table?
Yep.
Yep.
I see
and
him.
I type, wait a minute. Look at all those answers.
Deduplicated the Brads.
And what if I want to change Sam to like Jack?
You probably don't want to do
Jackal.
That.
Then you get the spill error
right.
saying you violated the integrity of the
of
result.
The, yep.
Here's
cool
one that
stuff.
Returns a random array of 4 rows, 8 columns, numbers between 1 and 1,000, and they don't need to be even integers. Very easy.
Awesome. That's another
Any
one.
Any of you using VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP, dark art, right? So XLOOKUP is our new friend, if I can spell them right, or I just click on the little helper there. The value I'm going to look up is in that cell. The value list that I'm looking it up against is right here. And the results that I want back are right there. So when I do that and I type Russia, or let's say, yeah, Russia.
Why not?
You see how it updated there. So XLOOKUP is going to make this stuff so much easier for you.
And with that, you passed year one, Demopalooza
okay.
One's number.
Let's keep going.
Keep going.
Don't slow me down. When I'm analyzing large amounts of data, I use ideas to democratize insights to be able to take action on that data. What's new and what I'm going to show you this year is the ability for you to ask questions about your data. Like, which brand had the most sales? Boom. Which category of Honda had? So now we're filtering. Let's go to the next one. Show me BMW sales over time. And this is my favorite. Compare it. Recursive. So it's going and looking at the prior query and
recursive search.
Upon
that's
it.
Actually worth 2 points. I think that was two okay. different demos in Excel. You're at 15 now.
Okay. Now I love Excel, but there are times when I'm without. And unfortunately, then sometimes I got to go, you know, to the calculator here. Now the challenge is when I launch another application, I don't know, do any of you alt tab, 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 tab to go find that calculator again? You find out you have 5 of them open. Guess what? Keep on top. There you go. Well, I'm going to create my document. That calendar's or the calculator's not
All right,
going anywhere.
Not bad.
Okay.
I was going to not give that to you, but I got the applause. So I'm going to give it to you this time.
All righty. Shall we talk about teamwork?
Let's talk about teamwork.
I use Microsoft Teams as my hub for teamwork. And this is my colleague Andrew, who appears to be phoning in from the moon. And so what I'm going to do here is turn on some live captioning here.
Cool. That's actually worth 2
and,
because he's
Andrew,
doing background swap and live captioning.
Well, I need the caption because there's no oxygen on the moon. So I'm not sure what you're doing up there. hey, how's it going, Andrew?
Hey, how's it going? I'm just on the moon here looking, doing a site survey for our next MTC location.
I guess 50 around
or
the world.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm just hanging out at your place and you get back from Ignite.
Oh, that's
all right, so
weird.
He's actually hanging out at your place. That's a little bit creepy.
Yeah. In fact, catch you later, man.
Right.
Okay. So that's a great use of Teams backgrounds, but obviously there are many more business appropriate use cases, but we just want to have a little fun here today.
Okay.
Now, the next thing I want to show you inside of Teams is something called secure private channels. And see, Jeremy, we actually kicked you out of this channel as we were planning.
There it is. That's another
before.
One. That's going to be one that people
right.
are going to love.
The next one
Very
is
cool.
the ability to double click and pop out your conversation.
Everybody loves this
window.
One.
Everybody loves that.
You're at
Unified
19 now.
Unified file sharing. Get ready for this one. I go into my team. Here's my engagements. I've got a file I've put in here. Now, all the people in my team obviously have access to this file. But what would happen then when I copy the link and then I go, say, try to engage somebody that is not part of the team? I'll give it, say, here to Kirk.
All
and
right.
now when I go into the IM here, and drop that message in here, you see I have the same file sharing controls that
awesome.
I have
that's
right
worth
inside the rest
20.
Of the team.
You're tied with last year. You got
right.
50 seconds left.
Oh, 50 seconds. Good Lord. Hey, how about multiple desktops that you can name? Goofing
that's
off
worth another one.
Files.
I love desktops. I
how
use them every
PowerPoint
day.
How about AI? Let's go talk. Oops. Oh, yeah, I got caught there, didn't
that's
I?
That's not the one
okay.
you want.
We're going to go to a blank presentation. I get blank page syndrome all the time. Cats. I love cats. Not really true.
All right,
but
let's,
okay.
let's see if the
And then
cats...
you see designer actually goes and fetches me a theme.
Oh,
that will
that's
make
amazing.
Cat lovers
All right, that's
delighted.
Worth 22. You're over,
now,
over the last year.
Finally, Last thing, request files. Drop off folder, I click on request files. This lets me bring them in from outside my organization securely. I give it a descriptive name like mechanics. I copy the link, now I'm gonna switch personalities and pretend I'm you, Jeremy. I'm gonna follow the link, and I'm gonna upload the file. Circle of care consent.
We're gonna give you just 1 second of stoppage time for this one to make sure it works on the right-hand side.
Watch the right-hand side. There's the file showing up in your drop-off folder.
Not bad, you got to 23, Jack. You did it, 10 minutes. Awesome, so congratulations, you killed it. That's three more than last year. And you didn't even need an awesome bonus round this time.
Yeah, what did I win? Did I get a Surface Go?
You can have that Vista thumb drive there that's still in your machine. There's a lot in the parking lot that I found this morning.
All right, well, I'd still like a Surface Go.
All right, it's about time to go. So can you tell us the best way then to get your hands on some of this stuff so all the folks here out in the audience can use what we're showing today?
Look, a lot of the stuff I showed you today is available in the Insider's Ring today, so I encourage you to be an Office 365 Pro Plus subscriber. That's where we put all the latest innovations, where you're gonna see it first. And then for the latest in Office and Windows, join up on the relevant Insider's program to gain access to the early preview builds.
And of course, you're going to want to keep watching the latest on Microsoft Mechanics. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you next time. And goodbye for now.